This camera is ultra wide angle compared with normal vision, so most items appear to be much further away than they are to us. In decent lighting, there is sharp focus across each frame, contrary to our eyes. We have a narrow field of high resolution, so be careful about interpreting these images. The other factor is its calculation of speed, which is the rate of change of the GPS coordinates over the last second. Fine in a straight line, but not accurate on sharp curves when the coordinate change is out of line with linear speed along the ground. It's also problematic with rapid acceleration or slowing down. This is another stage of the Missing Link project on the A417, with the old air balloon roundabout still in use.
Exit the roundabout onto A417.
Thank you.
an unusual move.
Turn left onto Cirencester Road.
This is the old Roman road, parallel to the modern A419, and is popular with cyclists. There's another one. Racing towards the end. Not too bad on a Sunday morning. The new road will be straight on from here. It's the one on the right that was closed.
Exit the roundabout onto A417. Continue for 4 miles.
What's the white van? Perhaps its maps are out of date, but it's a while now since the layout was changed. The climb over the railway. The short second lane is only useful when there is something heavy in this lane to start and rest here. The little car is struggling with the gradient onto the slip lane with a 70-mile-an-hour road. At least the slip is fairly long and level from here on. A bunch of battery electric buses from Newport covering the 7-tunnel closure today. A considerate driver ahead, so we can pass the bin emptying truck. Be wary of the illusion caused by ultra-wide-angle lenses. Things can look further away than they are with normal vision. Take account of known dimensions and measure distances from the coordinates on display when interpreting clips of this kind.